time, Julia. Just firstly, if we could start with Leighton, these half-year numbers. What do you think, though? Do you think this news about this investigation into possible irregular payments in Iraq may overshadow Leighton's shares today?
I think the market will be focusing on the added uncertainty which will be added into Leighton's business because of this investigation. If we actually look at the half-year results, no surprises in this result, given that we did see Leighton's coming out to the market in January, so less than a month ago, and updating the market. And back then in January, we saw them upgrading their guidance from underlying of $250 million and upped it to $270 million. So the underlying profit has come in line with expectations. No surprises to see that a strong part of their business remains the construction and the contract mining services. We've still seeing some of the project problem projects weighing on the result, in particular the desalination plant. But Leighton's is working through its problem projects, and that they are starting to near completion, so having less of an impact. If we have a look at the profit result, the statutory profit result coming in at $340 million, which of course is a massive turnaround from the previous corresponding period where we did see a loss of $409 million. So if we have a look at Leighton's, no surprises. They've also reiterated their full-year guidance, operating profit of $600 to $650 million. So in terms of Leighton's result, all priced in, given that we saw that update in January, so the market may focus on the news that we are seeing a federal police investigation into potential bribes, and that may add some uncertainty into the shares, and we could see a little bit of weakness.
All thoughts on it too. Early indications on the share market, shares doing quite well so far, up over 4% at $12.50.
Well, we know that JB Hi-Fi has been going through a difficult time, and if we have a look at the previous update, we've already seen an update for the first 5 months of the year. So really what we're getting today is the update for the extra month to the 6 months of the year, and then also an insight into January and February. And we know that in terms of the first 5 months of the year, we were seeing a loss, comparable like-for-like sales down by 1.8%. That's accelerated for the 6 months. We're now seeing like-for-like down by 2.2%. Also, if we have a look at JB Hi-Fi and have a look at the updates for January and February. January is a big month because that, of course, represents the post-Christmas sales. And in terms of January, like-for-like sales actually down quite substantially, down by 5.5%, although February did see a slight improvement, and that was up by 1%. So it does look like sales momentum in terms of January was once again disappointing. So no post-Christmas cheer for JB Hi-Fi, although there are small signs that we are seeing improvement in February, but of course we're only a few weeks into February at the moment. I guess the big thing I was watching in terms of JB Hi-Fi was the EBIT margin, and we know that margins have been under pressure because what we've seen from some of the competitors of JB Hi-Fi is that they're probably clearing some of their stock at below cost, and that means a pressure on margins, and we've certainly seen that flow through. If we have a look at EBIT margin coming in at 6.8%, that's down from 7.5% in the previous corresponding period. So those margins coming under quite a substantial pressure. But I guess if we have a look at JB Hi-Fi share price performance in the last year, we have seen a battered down quite a bit, so a lot of that already baked into the price.
Yeah, and as we mentioned there, two on the market's direction as well, and what you make of this this historic vote. Finally, the Greek political parties coming together and approving this package that's needed for them to get bailouts so that they don't end up in bankruptcy and perhaps out of the euro.
Friday, the leads for our market have been negative. We saw a negative lead from the US market, where we did see the biggest falls in the US market that were seen in around about 6 weeks. We've seen the VIX index taking a spike up. But if we have a look at all indications, it does look like it's going to be a positive backdrop for risk assets. We've seen that Greek parliament vote going through in favour of the austerity measures which have been agreed upon, and generally that should provide a good backdrop. If we have a look at some of the risk assets we know are already trading, that's in terms of currencies. The euro versus the US currency this morning has seen a massive move. You can see that in the last half hour we've seen the euro versus the US currency spiking. Most commodities are traded in US dollar terms, so that's a good backdrop for commodities despite the big falls that we saw in copper on the LME overnight. So while we have seen BHP Billiton open down about 0.3%, we could see some support for commodities coming through on the back of some of these currency movements that we've seen, and overall risk rally environment on the back of this Greek austerity vote. But of course the market will be looking soon to longer term measures, and if we have a look at Greece, this is the second bailout, 130 billion euros this bailout will be, and that's after the first bailout of 110 billion euros. So they were calling for their second bailout around about 1 year after that first bailout. So I guess question marks on whether we're going to see another bailout package in 2013. To support Greece. But for the time being, in terms of the short term, risk assets do seem to be rallying, especially in terms of the currencies, and that should be a positive for the Aussie market today.
Yeah, and just on